Hi guys, we're gonna work on a project I've kind of been putting off, to be honest, because I'm not sure, I'm a little scared about making this project. I'm not sure I actually own the skills to pull it off or not, but we're gonna find out, good or bad or ugly. I'm gonna film it because I'm nuts that way. All right, so this is a tote bag from the Ranger booth at Creativation that I picked up while I was there in Phoenix recently, helping out Canvas Court Brands, and they were giving these away. Now, not only does this tote bag have fabulous artwork on it, because most of the time when you go to trade shows like this, this is the type of bag that you get. I do like this bag. I love Dritz products, and this is nice muslin. That being said, you usually get this, or you get something more like this Hobby Lobby bag. That's just kind of a mesh, something that's, you know, cheap and inexpensive and lightweight. This Ranger bag is not only not plain, it's covered front and back and bottom with Tim Holtz artwork, but, well, his, you know, like grunge papers and stuff. It's got Tim Holtz ideology on both sides. And it's made out of the same material as these. If you have one of these bags, this tote bag is the same material. I pulled mine out just to double check that my thinking on that was correct, and it is. And I use mine to keep my knitting needles in, the few that I own still, FYI. So I think what we're going to do is we're going to make a travel case out of this. I would really like to have something that fits in my travel suitcase that I can put everything in that's in this travel wallet and this travel wallet into one bag. First of all, I don't know if I have the skills to make said thing. It's a little bit more of a advanced sewing project, figuring out just the math for this. And I'm not going to draft a pattern or anything, but I'll give you guys measurements as I have them as we go along. So you, honestly, you're just going to have to replay the video. I'm sorry. If somebody out there wants to use my measurements that I say in the video to create some kind of document for everybody that we can download, I would appreciate that. You can message me. My email is in the description below. Anyway, so I really like the idea of these zippered bags that you can unzip, that open flat. This one is not big enough to hold everything in both of these, so I'm really thinking something that's a little bit bigger, that maybe has more pockets to it and more heft to it, but that still fits in the bottom of my case. This is my actual travel bag. I emptied it out for this. So I was looking at this and thinking, for the outside cover, if I fold this in half and cut this top part off where the handles are, that actually sort of fits in the bag, and that might work. That might work. Maybe. I don't know if it's going to hold everything I need to when all is said and done. I don't know, but we're going to try it and we're going to see. So I'm going to put all this aside. We're going to do the scariest thing first, which is cut the bag apart. So, here we go. Holy cow. I'm going to cut right underneath this stitching line and basically just separate the top of the bag from the bottom of the bag. Just right underneath the stitching line. So I want to save as much of the fabric as I can. I should have grabbed two of these bags because it's such a pretty bag. But I didn't think about that till afterwards, and they were all out by the time I went back. Because of course they were. Everybody probably had the same idea as me. What a cool bag. I love all the old vintage papers he's got printed on this fabric. I think it's fabulous. All right. So there we have it. We've got the top off. I'm gonna just make a little pile of stuff on the floor. Now, I do think I'm going to line this bag with just plain unprinted canvas. It's the best, most sturdy thing. This fabric is nice, but it's not super sturdy, I don't think. And I really just want this for the outside cover. So now I'm going to cut this piping off. Or, it's not piping, bias tape. This stuff off the edges. Again, as close to the stitching as we can get. To just basically just disassemble the bag. So if you have, maybe you have a bag that you want to do this to, or maybe it's some other kind of garment. You want to just take it apart in a way that you're saving as many of the big, pretty pieces of fabric as you can. And I might not use these today, but I'm going to save them because I think they're cool. I'm going to put these two pieces aside because I'm pretty sure I'm not going to need them. Now we're left with this. Look at this piece of fabric now. It's very cool. So I'm still thinking if I took a piece like this size, and that's basically my outside cover. This is a zipper I got at Hobby Lobby. Now I wanted to get a zipper like this because it has two pulls on it. I don't know. I don't know if this is the zipper I'm going to want to use or not. We'll find out. I don't know. But it is how it's 28 inches long. I do have a box of zippers. So yeah, so I think that, and this is really the maximum size again that I think is going to fit in my case. And I do think I want to add some to the sides, each side of the zipper, some of this fabric, so that instead of having it like this, where this part, this is the zipper, that it's actually a little deeper, so we have a little piece of fabric there, so it's a little bit, got some room to really stuff it fat, or I think at least. All right, so let's just bite the bullet here and cut this piece of fabric off. What side do I want? I think I want this side. So I'm gonna just cut along one of the folds here for the bottom of the bag. Of course, I'm gonna save the rest of this fabric because I know I'm gonna probably want it for a future project. So now we want to cut a piece of the canvas that's the same size as this piece of Tim Holtz bag fabric, which is, let's see, I need my, here we go. So it is 15 by like 11 and 3 quarters. Okay. So we're going to take a piece of this. Actually, we're going to cut two pieces that are the same size as that piece of fabric, Tim Holtz fabric. I'll show you why in a minute. So I'm just going to just do low tech way. Try not to cut this wire because you know what? This is to my sewing machine. Let's put it up here. All right. So now we have an outside fabric, a piece of inside fabric. I want to put pockets and flaps on the inside. So the first thing I'm going to do is I'm going to cut this extra piece of plain fabric in half. And then I'm going to trim a little bit of it off. Well, do I need to trim it? Because I might have, I'm probably going to hem it. I probably don't need to trim it, so let's actually not do that. Because I'm going to hem it. And once I hem it, which I don't normally do, y'all know that. Usually I just leave the edges raw. Or do I want to just leave them raw? I think I'm going to just leave them raw. I'm going to trim about, I don't know, a half an inch or so off of one edge. Okay. We're going to take this fabric and some more of our canvas. And we're going to cut out some pieces on these two flaps that will be on the inside to arrange some pockets that will go this way to hold different things, pens and pencils, and some pockets probably that go that way. Plus, these are themselves going to be a pocket, and I may add another pocket that goes that way. So I'm going to do that. I'm going to speed forward through it, and I'll be right back. Okay, so here are, I think, are my two sides, and I'm going to sew them up really quick. I'm not going to fast forward through that part, and then we're going to trim them because obviously some of the pieces, like these pockets here, are bigger than this piece they're going to get sewn to. After I get them sewn and trimmed, then we'll take some measurements. So let's do the sewing first. We'll put our pull our machine over. Like, I'm going to try to have it like that. You won't really be able to see exactly what I'm doing, but I think you'll get an idea. So here's the inside left flap. And this part, you're going to be able to put things in. This part, put things in. So these pockets this way, which will be for pens, pencils, rulers, that kind of thing, I want to sew to this. If I sew them through all the layers, then you won't be able to get in here. So that'll be bad. So we're going to take and we're going to sew them to this upper one. We're going to set that one aside. And the first thing we're going to do is do a line of stay stitching here across the top so that these will fray a little bit, but they won't go too far. And I'm going to set my machine to sort of a medium straight stitch. This is the little Janome, so it doesn't, you know, have a lot of choices, but that's all right. I've got just some white thread in here. There's not much left on the bobbin, so my guess is I won't get very far before I have to refill the bobbin. Make sure you go back and forth at the beginning and end of each piece. Thread came out of the needle. Okay, that's not helpful. I'm like, why does that look funny? Because the thread came out of the needle. Well, let's try that again, shall we? I need my reading glasses for this. The eye of the needle is teeny tiny. As I'm threading the needle, I will tell you this video will probably be in two or three parts so that I don't bore you all with one super huge long video. That being said, there probably won't be too much of it that's sped through. If I do that, then you're going to probably miss something important. So just to warn you. Got it. also going to do all the way down one side of this piece and the bigger piece that this is going to get sewn to. Oops. Except I'm not paying attention to what I'm doing. Whoops. And I'm just stitching about a quarter of an inch away from the fabric edge. You can, of course, trim it if you want to roll it and trim it. Now I'm gonna just snip them all apart. Trim any sticking out sewing threads off. Okay. And then we can start assembling the left side of our pocket. I'm gonna go ahead and pull some of these loose fraying threads off. So the first thing I'm going to do is put a label on the smallest pocket that says made by and my name. I have these new ones I just got from Etsy. I'll try to put the link to the Etsy seller in the description below. And they have cute little bluebirds on them. Whether you intend on keeping the piece or selling it or giving it away, you should put a label on it. Put your name on it, sign your piece of artwork, own it and be proud. Oops. I had my foot on the pedal before I was ready. Again, trim the threads. Now we're going to sew our smallest pocket to our biggest pocket. I'm really doing this in a similar fashion to how I do the traveler's notebook covers. I'm going to line this up with this edge here because that's really what we're going to stitch down, and then I can do the trimming from this other edge, I think. Well, maybe I need to trim it first. Let's see. I think I need to trim it first. All right, let's trim this one. I could use this. Might be easier. This is a Fisker rotary tool. If you're not using it with a ruler or straight edge, please be careful and keep your fingers out of the way. Okay, much better. Now let's put this one. And we can sew this down and then trim it. So we're going to sew the little pocket to the bigger pocket. I'm going to line them up at the bottom. And again, I'm going to use that same quarter inch away from the edge seam allowance. at the top of the small pocket where I, when I'm done with my stitching, I'm really going to go back and forth a couple of times in order to give that some extra strength right there where it's attached. And we're not going to worry about this part here. We are going to stitch on it, but we'll do that in just a minute. Threads. Besides the Traveler's Notebook sewing tutorial, I also have one for doing it on a composition book somewhere on my channel. So now that I have it sewn, I'm going to trim this excess fabric off the edge of the small pocket. My table has a cutting mat on it. That's what this grid is. So I can just do it right on my tabletop. If you don't have that, then you're going to want to put a cutting mat underneath where you're doing this. If you're using a rotary tool. Okay. I'm going to put that over there because it's got a sharp blade on it so I don't cut myself. So now I'm going to take the smaller of the two left side pocket, large pockets, and I'm going to sew these smaller pockets to it, lining them up at the bottom. And I'm going to sew them all the way straight down this edge, double, going back and forth a few times at the top here. And I'm also going to sew them down over here the same way. See how this little machine does with all this thickness of fabric. This is a lot of fabric, and I really haven't sewn anything with this weight of canvas on this little machine with this many layers. So we'll see. At some point I may have to bring out the bigger machine, but we'll find out. I would like to see how this one does, so we'll find out. Now I'm going to sew the other side. Oop. That sounds like we need more bobbin thread. All right, so let's pull that out. Pull the bobbin out. Pull the thread out of the top. I'm going to wind the bobbin, and I will be right back. Okay, I think that's done, right? Let's find out. Seems to be working. Okay. Now we're going to sew this set. Now we have a pocket here. Pocket here. So we're going to take this and we're going to sew it to this bigger piece around these three edges. So we have a pocket here. Always hold your thread at the beginning and end when you start stitching, or at the beginning when you start stitching, so you don't get a big knot at the bottom underneath. You can can let it go after you make that first couple stitches. You hear how the machine's a little bit louder? It's because there's a lot of fabric. This little machine wasn't really made for sewing this kind of canvas. So as I'm going along, you'll see me constantly doing this and taking the extra threads off. Once you have, you know, a few of them off, it's gonna, you'll start to get this fun frayed look and it will start to look less raggedy. Okay, so that's the one side done with the pockets. So let's do the other side. So for the other side, I want to do it a little differently. So the first thing I'm going to do is I'm going to do my row of stay stitching a quarter inch in from each one of these three edges, these three long edges. Okay. Gotta find my thread ends. There we go. Once I've got them all sewn along that edge, then I'm gonna cut them apart. And you'll notice that neither time did I bother to separate my pieces of fabric and cut all the threads. I just kept sewing. I don't know what you call that. It was just sort of a, I used to work in manufacturing for Chuck E. Cheese. And you didn't stop in between pieces, you just kept going. It wasted too much time to stop in between each set of Chuck E. Cheese ears. So I'm gonna, that one seems to be pretty good. So the first thing I wanna do is take my smallest one and my next smallest one. And I'm going to sew them so that we have pockets that go this way. So I wanna divide it into thirds, I think. And I'm gonna just finger press it because I really just need that line. Yep. And then we're going to stitch up that line. Just like with the other pockets, when you get to the top opening of the pocket, go back and forth a couple of times. Okay. And then I'm going to trim all the threads. I'm gonna have to vacuum my room after this. Okay, and then we're gonna take, now we have this, and we have this. So we're gonna take this piece of fabric and we're gonna sew it to this bigger piece around these three edges. And what that's gonna do is it's gonna give us one pocket and then these three smaller pockets. And you'll notice I'm not pinning everything. I'm just sort of holding everything in place. I can't be bothered to take time for pins. That's the honest truth. Always, when you need to turn the corner, stop with the needle in your fabric, lift your presser foot up, and then just turn the fabric and then keep going. That'll give you a nice sharp corner. Threads again, and this one has a little bit of extra fabric hanging over, so I'm going to trim it. I don't mind a little bit extra fabric, but too much is too much. Okay, so now we have this one, which has a pocket here. It will have a pocket here, and then these three little pockets. Alrighty. So now we're going to take our inside piece and we are going to sew one to this end and one to this end. So let's do one at a time. Oh, I was going to measure the pockets for you. Okay, so this is the one with the two pockets that go this way. And the flap itself is about 7 inches by about 11 3/4. And the pot, this smaller flap is about 5 3/4. And so are these two in width. And then the height of the larger pocket, this one is 7 1/4 about, and this one is about 4 3/4. Okay, so let's sew this down. I got this canvas at Hobby Lobby. Most of your fabric stores carry canvas or duck cloth, which is a really thick quality, strong canvas. It comes in colors. I usually always use the natural, but it does come in colors. This will be the test of this little machine, if it can get through all these layers of canvas and stitch this down. We'll see what happens. I'm actually going to stitch this from the back side so I can make sure I don't miss any of the fabric. Now that I'm thinking of it. So I'm going to center it. There you go. The threads and check it out. There we go. So we have this flap and this flap, and now these two pockets. Nice. All right, let's do the other side. Now, of course, you could, if you know you don't like the frayed edge look, then you could take time and hem all your edges or use bias tape or something. Machine's struggling a little bit, but it's actually doing much better than I thought it would, to be really honest with you. We have this other side with all these pockets on it. Let's see. Before we go any further, let's make sure it fits in the case. Yes, it does. Okay,